I need a piece of ash. I'm kind of keeping my eyes open for one to make an axe handle for that broad axe. You know, when I was thinking ash all along, and there happened to be a pretty good piece of ash that the beavers knocked down, and they just take the top branches and leave the rest. But unless it was knocked down at least 2 years ago, but it's clear with no branches up to about there. I only need about that much. And it's been up so it isn't rotten. You know, it was still hanging on the stump. So I think I can take that. As long as I'm here, I'll take the rest and bring it home, use it for firewood. But I think, you know how on the butt of a tree always kind of flares out? And I'm thinking I can splitter, and the flare of that butt will give me enough that I can stay with the grain and make the offset for the handle. But I won't know until I actually get her split. But I got the miniature Husqvarna. I haven't run it for a while. Well, Yeah, I think I got something I can work with there. But I'll bring her down. I'm gonna get away from the heartwood. That gives me good grain. Yeah, that'll work. She's stringy, but she'll work. Okay, after I split this piece of ash, I took the chainsaw, started cut the way everything that wasn't handled. And I kind of reassembled them so you could see. Okay, first I cut the two side pieces off. That's got the sapwood in it that I didn't need. So then I was left with the outside sapwood and the inside that had the heartwood, which I wanted to get rid of. So I cut them off. Now that leaves me with an approximate handle. Though I yet have to, you know, and it's got the offset in the end. I still have to take off a little bit more of the heartwood on the inside of the handle, because this is flat, you know, on the inner part. So that has to stay flat on the handle. So I have to take this down a little bit more, like I say, just to get rid of the heartwood. And then I can curve this to fit into there. But by doing it this way, the grain is in perfect alignment, you know, because it was split out. You know, you can see it run just right all the way down. It's just as good as it can be. But it is what they used to do with the old double trees and single trees for horse pulling equipment. The stuff was split out. It wasn't sawn out. You know, if you just go and saw a piece out, the grain can be any old direction. That isn't as strong as if you split it. Get it. Follow the grain, because grain is what matters. But I'm going to start the saw. So I'm going to clean the snow off of this stuff. I wondered where the pens went. So that will dry off. And I can get back at it tomorrow, because this thing sits outside all the time, which is why everything is covered with snow. But then I'll get back at this. But my whole thing now is just to get her cleaned off, because we got enough sun to thaw. It's a lot more comfortable working on a tank covered with snow. And then I do have still another half that I can always make something out of. You know, a handle. That works. I can't imagine a better way of doing it. Then when the car done, I burnt the pine tar into it. And I wiped her down again just to get rid of any stuff that's left on top. But now I'm going to coat it with the hot stuff and leave it set again. And I got about a 2-inch offset on the handle. And the grain runs just perfectly true. In fact, maybe it shows better underneath here. You can see where it follows the whole length of the handle. So I'm calling her done. She should do the job.